So now let's read Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Once upon a time, a king and queen had a beautiful baby girl. When she was born, snow was falling in soft flakes outside, so they named her Snow White. Soon after, the queen died and the king married again. The new queen was vain with a cruel, cold heart. Every morning, she would gaze in her mirror and ask, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of us all?" The mirror would always reply, "You are," until one dreadful day when it said, "Snow White." Snow White had become the sweetest, kindest girl in the kingdom. The queen hated her. And the queen's jealousy grew until she summoned the royal huntsman. "Take Snow White to the forest," she snapped, "and leave her to die." The huntsman was horrified, but what could he do? "Run," he begged Snow White. "Keep running until you find help." Heart thumping, legs pounding, Snow White ran. He ran through the night and into the dawn. At last, she came to the edge of the forest. There stood a curious little house. Snow White crept up to it and knocked, rat-a-tat-tat, on the door. Seven dwarfs came rushing out. "Hello," they chorused. "Welcome, come in, come in." Jiggling and jostling, they bustled her inside. Then they set her down and Snow White told her tale. "The queen is wicked," they said, with a shake of their heads. "Stay with us, we'll look after you." The next morning, the queen strode up to her mirror. "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of us all?" "Snow White, of course," the mirror declared. "She's still alive," screeched the queen. Almost bursting with rage, she donned a disguise and hobbled through the forest. With a rat-tat-tat-tat, she knocked at the dwarf's door. "Pretty ribbons for a pretty girl," she croaked, trying a sash around Snow White's waist, tighter and tighter and tighter, until Snow White gasped and collapsed to the floor. And there she stayed until the dwarf found her. "Quick, undo the sash," they cried. "It must have been the evil queen." The next morning, the dwarf set off for work. "Be careful," they told Snow White, "and don't try on any more sashes." Snow White was busy sewing when she heard a young girl call out, "Glittery combs for sale." "Here, try one," said the girl, holding it up. But as Snow White placed it in her hair, she fell to the floor once more. "Ha!" chuckled the girl, turning into the villainous queen. "My poison comb will finish you for good." The dwarf arrived just in time to snatch the comb away. When the mirror announced that Snow White was still the fairest of all, the queen was furious. "I will get rid of her," she snarled, and she cast a terrible spell. Crisp, sweet apple, rosy red, just one bite and fall down dead. Disguised again, the queen returned to Snow White. "Try my scrumptious apple," she chewed. Snow White took a bite and dropped lifeless to the ground. This time, the dwarf could not help her. "She's too lovely to bury," they sobbed and placed her in a glass coffin. After a year and a day, a prince rode past. "That poor girl," cried the prince. He swept her into her arm and the piece of apple flew from her mouth. "Oh," murmured Snow White, opening her eyes. It was true love. Snow White and the prince married a year later, and all seven dwarfs carried her train. Now that's the end.